Welcome to GEMDELUX. In this video, we are going to talk about top 10 things about citrine. Before starting this video, please like this video, and subscribe to this channel for our future updates. Citrine is a translucent, coarse-grained silica mineral type, QV. Citrine is a semi-precious gem known for its yellow to brownish color, and similarity to the more valuable topaz. Citrine gets its color from colloidally suspended hydrous iron oxide. As compared to amethyst or smoky quartz, both of which are often heated to change their natural color to that of citrine, natural citrine is extremely rare. Citrine is often sold under a variety of names that confuse it with topaz in order to artificially inflate its price. It differs from topaz in terms of hardness, and from decolorized amethyst in terms of lack of reddish cast. Amethyst is found in Brazil, Uruguay, the Urals, Scotland, and North Carolina, among other places. It has quartz-like physical properties. Citrine was a common gemstone in retro, postwar jewelry, and was often used as the center stone in large cocktail rings. Citrine is re-emerging in sophisticated designs, as the jewelry world welcomes colored gemstones of all forms. Appealing to brands because of the availability of greater carat weights than many other gems, and its cool warm hue, citrine is re-emerging in sophisticated designs. Number 10. According to most accounts, the term citrine comes from the French word, citron, which means lemon. According to some sources, it may also be derived from the Latin word citrina, which means yellow. Only after 1556 was the word citrine used. The stone had previously been identified only as yellow quartz. The Romans are believed to have been the first to wear citrine, which was often in the form of cameos and intaglios. Number 9. Citrine is also known as the merchant stone. It is thought to attract wealth and achievement. Citrine in your pocket or purse, according to legend, can not only draw money, but also help you preserve it. Has anybody checked to see if it's accurate? During the Romantic era, it was discovered that the citrine's honey tone enhanced the elegance of gold jewelry, which led to a revival in popularity. Number 8. For a long time, citrine was thought to have magical properties. It was thought to defend against the plague, snake bites, spider bites, and bad people during medieval times. I'm relieved that the first three are no longer a concern. Citrine should be handled with care because it is easily scratched, and its color can disappear permanently if exposed to direct sunlight for an extended period of time. Number 7. With the naked eye, distinguishing cut citrine from more costly yellow topaz is virtually impossible. The hardness of the gems is the biggest difference between them, so bring your gem testing tools with you. Number 6. The majority of citrines are heat-treated amethysts or smoky quartz. Citrine's natural yellow color is light, but heat-treated stones have a richer hue, often with a faint reddish tint. I hope you are not disappointed when you discovered that your favorite citrine jewel was actually a heat-treated gem. Number 5. The world's largest citrine, weighing 2,258 carats, is on display at the Smithsonian in Washington. The gem is enormous as compared to the average size used in jewelry, which is under 25 carats. The most valuable citrines are natural gems with saturated colors, also known as Madeira citrine in the trade. The name comes from a fortified Portuguese wine produced on the Madeira Islands, and the color of such quartz can vary from golden to golden orange to reddish brown to brown. Number 4. Citrines are primarily produced in Brazil. They can also be found in Madagascar, Zambia, Namibia, Russia's Ural Mountains, and several other countries that have amethysts. I now have yet another excuse to travel to those countries. Citrines are easily scratched and require special care. Citrine jewelry should be kept out of direct sunlight because the color will fade over time. Number 3. It is believed that the Romans were the first to wear citrine, which was often in the form of cameos or intaglios. During the Romantic era, the gem regained popularity as it enhanced the elegance of gold jewelry. Citrine jewelry is very common nowadays, so the gallery with the most recent honey-colored jewels will be up soon. Citrine should be handled with care because it is easily scratched, and its color can disappear permanently if exposed to direct sunlight for an extended period of time. Number 2. Most citrines are actually amethysts or smoky quartz that have been heat treated. Citrine's natural yellow color is light, but enhanced stones have a richer hue, often with a faint reddish tint. With the naked eye, distinguishing faceted citrine from more costly yellow topaz is nearly impossible. The key distinction between citrine and yellow topaz is their hardness, with topaz rating an 8 on the Moss scale and citrine a 7. Number 1. The Smithsonian's famous Jolie Citrine necklace is another fascinating citrine exhibit. It features a 177.11 carat pear cut citrine drop in further, complemented by 64 graduated bezel set cushion cut citrines, all set in 18 carat yellow gold. The necklace was designed in 2015 as part of Angelina Jolie's Style of Jolie jewelry line, which is the product of an artistic partnership between the actress and noted American jeweler Robert Prokop. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go.